Hi, I'm Michelle Zube. I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with DiNovi and Associates.
And I'm Alicia LaBruna. I'm a Clinical Associate with DiNovi and Associates. Today we're going to talk to you guys a little bit about how we utilize four main behavior analytic principles: goal setting, self-monitoring, feedback, and positive reinforcement to help us stay motivated to live healthy and active lifestyles
and to meet our fitness goals. Since I train different things, for yoga, I think it's more of like a mindfulness, like not getting distracted, trying to stay more focused and on task with my breathing and just staying in the moment with the class. For boxing, if I'm sparring that day, it's definitely punches landed, not punches landed on my face or my body for that matter. With jiu-jitsu, I would say my goal setting is a little bit different. Like, it's more, because we're not always like in a, like fighting or going live rolling, but it's more just like the amount of moves that I can sort of chain off of one another.
Mm-hmm.
So that's like more of a goal setting there in the short term, like per session. How about you for the gym?
Yeah, I'll say for long-term purposes, I make sure that I set goals for the week to make sure that I'm staying on track to having enough workout sessions within my
mm-hmm.
week. So, and then go like monthly as well. So if I can schedule in, I'll make sure, okay, I want to hit the gym at least 5 times
mm-hmm.
this week, whether it be kickboxing or weightlifting or whatever, depending on the schedule for that day and then how much time I have allotted will help me figure out what's going to be better for like to fit in that block.
Right.
So I know that the gym is going to probably take me a good 2 hours. If I don't have the 2 hours to fit in that day, say it's a Tuesday, on a Tuesday I'm going to make sure I schedule in a kickboxing class
right.
instead of the gym. Maybe on a Saturday I'll have the 2 hours to hit for whatever body part I'm training at the gym.
Yeah.
So that just helps to keep it organized, but also reach that goal of, okay, I'm going to hit it 5 times this week. And also making sure that I set it realistically. Like, a lot of people are like, I'm going to go to the gym every day this
right.
week, and
you're
never going to reach that. exactly. But if you say, you know, this week's packed, let me set my goal for at least 3 days out of this week.
Now,
then I can be successful.
With your, since you do two different things, like, are you trying to goal set, like, to be at the gym lifting weights 3 times and then, like, kickboxing twice a week?
So, over time, just from training and stuff like that, I found out what worked best for my body type
mm-hmm.
to attain whatever goal I was trying to hit
right.
as far as like aesthetically or, you know,
strength wise
cardio. Exactly. So for me, I know that I need to schedule in a lot more cardio than weightlifting. I like to do that, at least train like 2 body parts a week, and then the rest of the days I'll do kickboxing. It's also not strictly cardio, it trains a lot of muscle groups as well.
Right.
So for me, that's the right balance between everything. But some people, like you said, might want to train like 4 days out of the week and do
right.
cardio 1 day. So it just depends on the person.
So for me personally, when I self-monitor both in training and outside of training. And I think it's important to do that because what you're doing is you're working towards a goal. And, you know, our goal is fitness that we're talking about, but really it can pertain to any goal. So when I'm looking at certain things, like we were talking about scheduling before and goal setting and trying to, you know, make classes or weight training, you know, a certain amount of days a week. But if that's not working out, you know, you want to make sure that there's not somewhere in your schedule that's tripping you up constantly. Like
mm-hmm.
you were saying, Tuesdays are a really rough day. So to try to schedule a 2 hour session would be, a 2 hour training session would be ridiculous
right.
on that day.
And not setting yourself up for success.
Right.
Then you'll probably notice that trend over time. Okay, every Tuesday I'm not meeting my goal.
Right. So that's what I do with my schedule. We were talking earlier about the sort of roadmap for my week that I make of all the different training schedules and different training times of all the things that I train. So I use that to self-monitor and I can kind of like check off, oh, okay, great. Like I went to yoga once a week and that's my goal. And I went to boxing twice a week. Sometimes if I exceed that and go 3 times, great.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just like one aspect of self-monitoring. I would say when I'm in a training session and I'm self-monitoring myself, it's really looking and seeing, am I meeting the goal for the class? So if like we're working on, say in jiu-jitsu, we're working on a particular move and we're trying to choke our partner out, am I able to do that? Like, am I fumbling in the move? And if I am, like, I need to take a step back, maybe go talk to the coach and, you know, reset myself and see where I'm making mistakes.
I think it's really important, going back to the scheduling piece, to do it in a way that works for you. Mm-hmm. It sounds silly, but it's true. Like, so, you know, some people just may take certain pieces of advice. Oh, you know, put it in your phone calendar,
right,
or put it, you know, write it down or use an agenda or whatever it may be. But it's the smallest change can make a difference. For me, I handwrite everything.
Mm-hmm.
And so, as tedious as that sounds in this technological age, writing it down, crossing it off,
yep,
or being able to erase it and move it somewhere or something,
definitely,
is just so immediate for me. And it's very, very hands-on,
mm-hmm,
instead of it being floating in some cloud somewhere.
Right.
I like to have it right there. So that's how, and then, you know, how many things do I cross off throughout the day? Okay, I can see clearly that I've completed all of these things.
Definitely.
So that's helpful for me. Once you, you know, just delete something out in a schedule that you type in,
no longer
it was never there. And for me, it's just more concrete to,
yep,
have it written down. So,
definitely,
I self-monitor a lot better that way. I personally like to video myself when I'm doing, certain new things that require me to learn like a certain form. So whether it be weightlifting or kickboxing, you know, there's a boxing bag at the gym and I want to know, what do I look like when I'm doing this and am I doing it appropriately? For fitness, form is everything, really. I mean, you could lift the heaviest weight you want to possibly lift, but you don't have the proper form, you're going to hurt yourself. So I want to make sure that I'm doing it appropriately, but sometimes it's very hard to give yourself that,
mm-hmm,
feedback when you're alone. You know, if you have a personal trainer, that's great. They can give you that feedback. But if you're alone, you may not have the best outlook on, you know, what you're doing exactly. So I videotape myself, and then I go back and watch it, and it takes, you know, a little extra time out of, you know, my gym session. But it's important because then I'm making sure that I'm getting the best quality workout that I can possibly be getting. Do you do anything similar to that?
Yeah, so during my boxing sessions, my coach will just grab his phone or my phone and he'll video certain things that I'm doing, and then he'll stop and we'll go back and we'll look and he'll say, oh, look at your footwork, or, you know, did you see, like, you didn't turn your hips enough, and then he'll send me more at night with his whole analysis of what I did incorrectly and what I did correctly. But it does, it really helps to see yourself, because we overcompensate in so many ways, you know, when we're doing these things, we compromise our form, and you lose a lot of strength, and, you know, you run the risk of injury,
mm-hmm,
when you're not doing something correctly. So that's been huge for me. I've also, with jiu-jitsu, videoed as well, and going back and looking and, like, seeing, oh, I totally could have done this instead of that, or, like, I you know, I put myself in that terrible position.
Sometimes you can hear feedback from,
mm-hmm,
someone else over and over and over,
yep,
again, until something sparks in you and you get that aha moment where you see it yourself.
Yeah.
So even if you have a trainer or a coach or something like that,
definitely,
if they're filming you so that you can go back and watch it yourself, it's not just someone's secondhand account. You're seeing that,
right,
and saying, okay, yeah, I'm accountable. That's
right,
what I did.
I see where I did that, what you're talking about. Yeah.
Exactly.
It helps too, you know, with the things that I do, you typically have a training partner. So it's really reinforcing when you're training with somebody and they're like,
mm-hmm,
yeah, you're crushing me. Or, yeah, that really hurt, you know. Kind of sucks for them. But getting that feedback in that moment where you're like, okay, cool. And then, you know, you're kind of saying to yourself, like, all right, like, I was putting the right amount of pressure. I was doing that. And,
mm-hmm,
then you try to, you know, keep replicating that. That's really, really helpful.
My reinforcer for staying on task or on track to meeting my goal for that week can really change week to week.
Mm-hmm.
1 week it might be a cheat meal, 1 week it might be going out to whatever event I might have to go to or something like that. You know, just telling myself, hey, when you get there, you can have this or that or whatever, you know, drinks or food. Or it could just be a cheat meal, or it could be we're going to the movies at the end of the week. But it needs, for me, it needs to vary because I'm gonna get satiated on one thing and it's not gonna be motivating anymore. So it does change, but also making sure that you're accessing reinforcement at the appropriate rate. So I like, you know, I about a week span I can give myself to work really hard and then earn something.
Right.
Some people might eat something at the end of every day, and some people might be able to last that 3 months until their vacation in Hawaii or whatever it may be before they, you know, cave in or get to earn something, you know, for the hard work that they've put in. So, like I said, for me, it's about at the end of the week, I like to pick a Saturday or a Sunday, just like dive in on like a cheat day. Yeah, and not limit myself, and you know, then that'll keep me going for the rest of the week.
One of the things I do too, I really like buying gym clothes.
Weird.
So weird. But like I just got a new gi for Christmas, but I would have bought myself a new gi had I not gotten one for Christmas. But because I've been consistently going twice a week now for over 6 months, I'm like, all right, I want to ramp it up to 3 times a week. I really need another gi. But to me, that's motivating.
Yeah.
Right? Like I'm working towards something.
I was working towards boxing gloves.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing.
All of our equipment. But yeah, I mean, I would say those are the things for me. Also, like if I have a really, really hard training session and I'm just like wiped out afterwards, I'm like, I just really did good. There's a pataya bowl place upstairs from where I train. Also happens to be next door to my yoga studio. Yeah, so I'm like, I'm gonna pataya bowl today. It's not really my cheat meal, but it's just something that I don't, it's like a special healthy treat. So all of the behavior analytic principles that we discussed today are really important because they will help you to stay on track and motivated and to meet the goals that you set for yourselves, whether they're fitness goals, healthy lifestyle, or some other type of goal. What ends up happening is once you start changing one behavior, a lot of other behaviors will start to change because of that, and you start to create this behavior chain. And you can see from the conversations that we've had, right, that you start to build some behavioral momentum. And it makes it a lot easier to meet these goals and maintain them in the long run.